We know our WhatsApp business channel can be shared as a link, QR code, in deep links, etc. But where can you place it? Where should you share your WhatsApp channel? Let's have a look at different examples to expand the reach of your WhatsApp business channel. In recent years, accelerated by the pandemic, we've seen businesses implement the QR code in spots and places we probably wouldn't have imagined. While some of these ideas might be genius, in this video, we'll take a more realistic approach, structuring the video by entry points to your WhatsApp channel. First, we'll start by asking ourselves the correct questions, trying to find an entry point strategy that fits our use case. Then we'll look at the different examples, starting with organic entry points and finishing with paid entry points. So let's start by defining an entry point strategy that fits your use case. Now, your marketing, commerce, customer care, and loyalty requirements determine where and how you place entry points. Ask yourself, what behavior do we want to encourage? For example, we could create a click to WhatsApp campaign and entry points next to product pages in order to generate pre-purchase product-focused engagement in WhatsApp. The possibilities are endless. So, where should we place entry points? There are a number of organic and paid ways to build awareness of your WhatsApp number across the customer journey. So let's have a look at the different types of entry points. Starting with organic social media. A persistent click-to-chat link in social media account bios is a great approach to customer support or lead generation. When tapped or clicked, the link will open a WhatsApp conversation. We can also place this link on a regular social media post or in the profile page story highlights. Another organic entry point would be your website. Inside your Contact Us page, you can have the WhatsApp number, text link, and/or a QR code. Keep in mind that tapping a link or scanning a QR code is faster and easier than manually typing in a phone number. The more prominent the placement, the more likely the people will choose WhatsApp to engage with your business. Providing information upfront on what users can expect from a business WhatsApp channel is key to drive user behavior. We can also have a live chat widget on our website. Copy and paste the snippet into your website and your users will be able to contact you on WhatsApp. The final organic entry point is your telephone. One would be when we have an interactive voice response, useful when we find ourselves during peak hours with highest waiting times. We can add a move conversation to WhatsApp option in your IVR menu. Now, let's get into paid entry points. Starting with Facebook and Instagram, we can create ads so that the call to action is a click to WhatsApp. So when users press on the button, they are redirected to WhatsApp. Other options are doing influencer collaborations to create social media posts to capitalize on the reach. Or we can also use traditional advertising, like using QR codes on product packaging, billboards, or other out-of-home locations like media and news articles. Keep in mind that these are just examples, probably the most popular ones, but as mentioned before, define what behavior you want to encourage from the user and from where. Then you'll be able to find the best ways to place your WhatsApp channel. I'm Nick, and I'll see you in the next one.